Sir, now I hope you people got basic idea about try with the resources. Sir, related to this, there are some important conclusions are there. Let me talk about these conclusions, right? Sir, the first conclusion here, observe, try with the resources. How many resources we can take? Is it only one or any number of resources we can take? Sir, simple answer, for try with the resources, you can take any number of resources, no problem, but all these resources should be separated with semicolon. Remember this one, sir, should be separated with semicolon. Now observe very carefully, try okay, resource 1, semicolon resource 2, semicolon resource 3, like we can take any number of resources, no problem at all. Resource 1, resource 2, and resource 3, any number of resources we can take, sir. Sir, can you please give an example? Very simple, sir. Try, I'm taking. Here, I want to read the data from input.txt. I want to write to output.txt. One reader is required, one writer is required. Are you getting? Two resources are required, to read data, to write data. To read the data, okay, file reader fr is equal to new file reader fr is equal to new file reader of input.txt, like this I took, sir. Sir, this is the first resource, semicolon. Now what is the second resource? Print writer pw is equal to, sir, which is the best writer to write extra data, print writer pw is equal to new print writer of output.txt, print writer output.txt, like this I'm taking, sir. So this is the second resource. So total how many resources I'm taking? First resource, second resource, and then, okay, like, sir, this is. Now it's very clear. So, try with the resources. How many resources we can take? We can take any number of resources, but all these resources should be separated with semicolon. Clear for all of it? Conclusion 1. Sir, now, second conclusion. Second one, sir. Whatever resources you are using, with try with resources syntax, compulsory these resources should be auto closable resources. Regarding what is this one, sir, can you please spell out? Auto closable resources. Whatever resources we are using, yada part of try blah, all these resources should be auto closable resources. Then automatically closed, auto closable resources. Then immediately you may get that down. Sir, what is auto closable? Where is the auto closable resource? When we say that a resource is said to be auto closable, very simple, sir. The corresponding class should implement java.lang.autoclosable interface. Okay, a resource is said to be auto closable if and only if the corresponding class implements auto closable interface. Are you getting that? If the corresponding class implements for auto closable interface, okay, that resource is said to be auto closable, right? Sir, in our last example, which resources we used? Have you observed? File reader I used. Next, print writer I used. Sir, these classes already implements java.lang.autoclosable, that's why. So we are not required to do anything, sir. One very important specialty, almost all database related resources, network related resources, file IO related resources already implements auto closable interface. So being a programmer, just we should aware this point, we are not required to do anything, sir. Observe a bit very careful in the API. Have a look once, sir. This is the API interface, java.lang.interface, auto closable. Okay, this is the interface, right? All known sub interfaces, all known implementation classes. If you observe how many implementation classes are there, just let me copy paste here. Sir, observe a bit very, very carefully about all these resources, right? Now, do you know, sir, all these resources are implementation classes only. You can take network related resources, file level related resources, next and after that, you know, database related resources. All these things already implements, auto closable. Being a programmer, we are not required to do anything, sir. Have you observed print writer? Print writer resource, okay? Like similarly file reader, I hope you can able to see, sir, this is the file reader resource, file writer resource. Are you getting? Filter input stream, like almost every database related, file IO related, network related, all these resources already implements auto closable. Being a programmer, we are not required to do anything, sir. Okay, well, next, this interface introduced in 1.7 version. In which version, sir? This interface came in which version? 1.7 version. And it contains only one method. Close is the method. Public void close throws exception. Public void close throws exception. That's all. Sir, this is the only one method which is available. Okay, like. Any doubt? Is it clear for all of you, right? Not required to keep much explanation about this terminology, right? Okay. So this is the second conclusion what you people should aware. Sir, up to this, we covered two conclusions about the try with resources. The third conclusion, sir. Sir, do you know whatever resource reference variables we used are implicitly final. Sir, what it means? Observe. Here I am taking file reader fr is equal to new file reader of input dot txt. Observe very very carefully, sir. Here which resource we are using? Can you please spell out which resource? File reader resource. What is the reference variable for this? Fr. So the biggest advantage, this fr will be closed automatically once the control reaches end of try block. Okay, now sir, who is the responsible to close? The syntax JVM automatically. So to do that, boss, within the try block, don't reassign this reference variable to any new resource. That means all resource reference variables are implicitly final. We can't perform reassignment for this resource reference variable inside try block. Have a look once. Here I am taking fr is equal to new file reader of abc dot txt. I am taking fr is equal to new file reader of abc dot txt. I am taking, sir. Do you know what is this one? What is this? I'm trying to reassign, sir, this reference variable which is pointing to new resource. So it is a new resource. I'm assigning reference variable with a new resource. Immediately compiler will get left and right. Hey, this reference variable is implicitly final. Within the try block, we are not required. We can't perform assignment. What is the problem, you may ask? The problem is fr initially pointing to input.txt. Sir, now fr is equal to new fr of abc.txt. Have you observed, right? Now it is pointing to abc.txt. At last, which one my JVM has to close? Either resource of input.txt or resource of abc.txt. It is always a problem. It's always a confusion. That's why this reference variable is always pointing to only one resource. By mistake, if you are trying to pointing to secondary resource, reassignment, immediately error we are going to get, sir. Compile time error, syntactical mistake. Now have a look once, sir. Same example here, see this one. Try file reader fr is equal to new file reader, like this I'm taking, sir. So I'm not performing any assignment. Okay, reassignment is not there, sir. Okay, now have a look once, sir. Let me compile this code. Have a look once, sir. Let me compile. Happily the code is going to compile. So just one small thing. File not found exception must be. Okay, save sign throws exception, right? Sir, now observe this one. There are no errors at all. there are no errors at all. Happily itself is acceptable, right? Okay, so there is no compile time error, there is no runtime exception. Okay, like it's a working right. Now by mistake, if I'm trying to reassign that resource regarding FR, now onwards it is pointing to abc.txt. Sir, I'm trying to reassign FR. Sir, now observe a bit carefully. What will happen is auto closable resource FR may not be assigned. Auto closable resource FR may not be assigned. This is the error by default you are going to get. Okay, take a bit very special care. So means that all resource reference variables are implicitly final. We can't perform reassignment inside the try block. This is the next conclusion what you should aware. Clear for all of you, right? Third conclusion also. Now there is one more conclusion is there. What that conclusion is, sir, observe carefully. This is the fourth conclusion, sir. Very important conclusion, sir. Just up to third one, resource reference variables are final. Okay, well, the next one, until 1.6 version, try block should be followed by either catch or finally. Correct, right? Try should be followed by either catch block or finally block. Try without catch or finally is invalid. Try without the catch or finally is always invalid. Immediately error you are going to get, compile time error. But from 1.7 version onwards, only try with the resource is always acceptable. Regarding, we are not required to write catch block, we are not required to write finally block. What is the advantage of this syntax? Yes, sir, the biggest advantage is even some exception is coming, abnormal termination, but before abnormal termination, sir, this resource will be closed. That is the biggest advantage, right? So try without catch or finally, happily we can write from which version onwards, right? 1.7 version onwards. In the last example, have you observed or not? This one I showed. If you want to observe, have a look once. I don't want to take this one. Okay, now observe. Just a try block with resource. Only try block I took, sir. Where is the catch block? Where is the finally block? I'm not taking anything. Now let me compile this code. Happily the code compiles fine. Let me run this code. Sir, we are not facing any problem at all. This syntax itself is acceptable. Remember, right? Okay, so I hope everyone can able to understand the fourth conclusion. Okay, try must be followed by either catch or finally until 1.6 version. Without catch or finally, try is not allowed. But from 1.7 version onwards, only try block, only try with resource is enough without catch or finally blocks. Okay, that's all. These are various important conclusions about try with the resources. Can you please tell what is the biggest advantage of try with resources? We are not required to close the resources explicitly. Resources will be closed automatically. Complexity of the programming will be reduced. Finally block, we are not required to write. Length of the code is going to be decreases. Readability will be improved. So until 1.6 version, finally block is a hero. But from 1.7 version onwards, because of try with resources, finally block will become zero. Remember this, because we are not required to write finally block. Sir, we are not required because try syntax only it is doing closing the resources. Finally block became zero from which version onwards? 1.7 version onwards. Clear, right? Sir, up to this, it is very clear about try with resources. So try with resources concept came in which version? 1.7 version, correct, right? 1.7. But in the 1.9 version, there is extra small facility added for this try with the resources. What that facility is, listen carefully, sir. Suppose I have one resource here, file radar fr is equal to new file radar of abc.txt. Assume that I have one resource is there, sir. Now here if I can take try of fr like this, immediately compile method we are going to get in 1.7 version. Remember this one. What the reason is, all resources whatever you want to use with the try, compulsory you have to declare this resource here only. Sir, already this resource is declared. Now I want to use already declared resources. Sorry, man, not possible. Compulsory, we should write in this style. What that style is? Try, sir, file reader fr is equal to new file reader of abc.txt. Okay, like so. In the try primary list only. Compulsory we have to declare the resource. Sir, resource already declared. I want to use already declared resource. Sorry, this type of thing not possible in the 1.7 version, 1.8 version. Remember this one, sir. But in the 1.9 version, in the 1.9 version, so already declared resources happily you can use, no problem at all. Sir, now file reader fr is equal to new file reader of input.txt. Okay, like similarly print writer pw is equal to new print writer of output.txt. Okay, like how many resources I open, can you please tell? Fr and then pw. Okay, two resources I open, sir. Now my requirement is try fr semicolon. What is the next one, sir? Pw. Okay, like happily you can write. So I'm not declaring the resources here, already declared resources we are using. This type of facility came from which version onwards? 1.9 version onward. But until 1.7, 1.8 version, this one is invalid. But from 1.9, happily, this facility is there, sir. So this is extra added a small favor in 1.9 version for try with resources. Clear?